Welcome to the talk show, The Power of Women in Business, the show for international businesswomen to get inspired with best practices and insights on how to scale up your business internationally. Your host is Tineke Rensen from Holland. She is well known for supporting female business owners to expand their business massively and internationally. Tineke is an international business expert for 28 years and is the author of the book, Maximum Business Growth for Women. It is time that women step up and create bigger businesses so that women can make a bigger impact in the world. Enjoy this powerful show as Tineke Rensen and her guest expert combine their brilliance in business to help you take your business to the next level.
So welcome everybody. Today I have a very, very special meeting because I have one guest, as you can see, Wilma Palin, but later on her daughter, who is the next generation, will join this episode of the Powerful Business Women as well. So hello Wilma, let me introduce you. This is Wilma Pele, and she has been the director of Sneeboer, which is a Dutch company, since 1986. She's a creative person who enjoys to work hard, and she loves to meet new people, especially her clients and customers. In 1986, she and her husband, Jaap, took over the company. And at that moment, Sneeboer was only a local company, where the uncle of Jaap was the blacksmith and where Wilma started to sell the products in a small shop. She saw quite fast that she could focus on the production and sale of stainless steel forced garden tools. Everybody should be able to experience and enjoy the high quality of their tools. The way she produces them, the way they take care of the environment, and the way of their blacksmith produce, the family organization and the high range of different tools, as you can already see behind Wilma, more than 240, is something that she's very, very proud of. Wow, Wilma.
Yes.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
That's a long time already.
Yeah.
Yes.
The company is founded already in 1913.
Yeah.
So we were the third generation who took over. Yes.
Excellent.
From the grandfather from Jaap, he started the company.
Yeah.
You know, a very small blacksmith in those days. And after the, I think 1915, they started only with garden tools.
Mm-hmm.
They only did garden tools, stainless steel and steel, because that was normally, you had a blacksmith, every village, maybe people will remember, had his own blacksmith, of course. Nowadays, yeah. You don't find many anymore.
No, true. And then you entered the business, and you decided you wanted to go from local to,
yes, to
country and global. Why did you make that decision?
Because there were a few things. I thought the product is to show more people that, you know, the stainless steel product is a product that's very high end, but it's good for the environment. And I believed in the product, and I believed in the way we made it. So and I speak my languages. So and I'm somebody who likes to expand, to look further than my town. I'm not born in where I live now. I'm born in the east part of the Netherlands. I moved. So I like to see more of the world and people. And the first customer we had was a big one in Germany.
Mm-hmm.
And later on, we had a very, very big article in Gardens Illustrated about our company. And that gives us a grow a little bit. So more and more we went to England, we went to Germany. And to be honest, we didn't do a lot of advertising. It was like, the people saw our products and said, yes, this is what we want. This is a beautiful,
yeah,
product people liked. So and so we grow organic, we always say.
Wow.
Because we have to make it by hand. We have to train people. So, but when I started, that when I took over the business, it was a little bit a man. It took some more people, more men came working at the factory. Mm-hmm. And for me, the first time it was difficult to, how should I do this? I was not used. So I did a training.
Okay.
I did a training from how do you become a successful woman? So I and that was training to learn and teach people and to give me the right tools. And so that's what I did when I started in 1986 to give myself more skills in the company.
That's very sensible. And can you remember what the most important thing was that you learned?
Yes, I can remember because I had one day. The thing was, I had a meeting with one of my staff. It was about his salary, you know, about his pension. And he was sitting on like this. And I was like, oh my God, I have to. And that was the moment that I needed the course, what I did, yes. And she learned me to give me the right hand tools, the tools to how to discuss it and how to prepare yourself. You are the director. Make yourself... be sure what you are. It was just somebody, you know, you need to, not to give you the right skills. You already knew probably, but I was more sure afterwards.
Yeah, that's what most women need. We always need just a little reassurance, we know, but when somebody else confirms, we go. So yes. So what I hear it was that you needed to step up and be a leader.
Yes.
Exactly. Yes. Yeah, good.
Well, I'm a leader. I know I am a leader. I know myself quite well. I don't take no for an answer. I'm somebody who, I always look further. I look to possibilities. And so, yeah, that's why it was just the step. It was something I need to know who I am. I knew. Yeah, correct.
And I assume you have improved and you have mastered your leadership skills and how to work with the men.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. What do you like so much about working? Because I remember you said most of the people you employ are men, and you said you really liked it. Why do you like it so much?
Well, men are quite easy to work with if you are honest. Men are like if the word is the word. If you say something, it's okay. That's it. Okay. And. Maybe it's because I'm the same, but we can work, and I'm family, because it could be difficult for some people, but I'm always honest. If you want to speak to me, mm-hmm. you just make an appointment, come to the office, and be open. But I think that's very important for the company. Mm-hmm. Just be honest and show who you are. Be open.
Yeah. Yeah, I like that. That's a good tip. You gave me some statements, things that you are very things that are important to you, and one of them is that women should be independent and need to be able to make their own money. Why do you believe that's so important?
I think women should be. It should be normal. It's not something we want them to be. But I teach Laura also to be independent. You have to look for yourself if something happens, a divorce, somebody dies, or I don't know what else. There are too many women still in the Netherlands who are dependent. They depend on their husband. They don't know what's going on. And I think it's important you should have your own skills. You have your own money. You should know where it is. Mm-hmm. I think that's something we could do more, much more for a lot of women. I think maybe we are not sure enough for ourselves, but it's important. Look after your own business.
Yeah. So exactly. So we talk about women in business.
I went into a lot of workshops, you know, and it's important to meet other people. Mm-hmm. And I did a lot of lecturing. I told people who I was, and the first time is terrible. You know, you stand there, you think, oh my God. But you teach yourself and talk to other people. That's important. I never, and I told my story. I always told who I was, and never told I had. If you listen to men, they never tell what their private situation is. women, we always feel a little bit like, yeah, I have two children, and I think that's not important if you run a business.
Mm-hmm.
I have two children also, we raise them, we did it both, it has nothing to do with my business, that's something we should, what I think, I never told.
Yeah. I agree. You know, in one way, we don't have to do the same men do. Right? We are different. But yeah, when people don't ask, I never bring up my kids as a subject either, you know, because you are in relationship because of the business. And yes. That's where it should be about.
Yeah. So, and it's, if you listen more to men, you obviously hear them. They always speak about the business.
Mm-hmm.
They are more self-assured, and we should be more. I learned that. I saw a lot of meetings and networking stuff. So you learn about it. And I thought, yeah. This is how it should be, I think. So,
yeah. Okay. Yeah. And you also believe that men take their chances a lot quicker and are less risk avoidant than we are?
Yes. The men, if they come, they are like, they have their plan. They are ready. To tell the story, they are more sure, and I think we could be more sure. We are sure, but we could learn about that. Avoid the risk, go for it.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, and if it happens, it's not something can happen. If you do business, yeah, it's a bit difficult to translate in Dutch. We say you go on your je gaat onderuit. You go.
You stumble over and you crawl back up again.
Yes.
Yeah.
And that's business. There you learn from, and the man always can tell you. You see them telling things that I think it's not always. They always look sure.
Yeah.
If it does.
Yeah.
And you could learn from that one.
And I like what you say. They look sure. It's not necessarily the case that they are sure, but they have this thing how in their aura or in their mimics that they don't come across insecure. And we can be like this,
yeah.
You know?
Attitude is better.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
yeah, I like that.
Yeah, me too.
So you have a role model. Who is she?
Who is she? Well, it's still Queen Maxima, our Dutch queen. Because I like the way she's doing the microcredit. She makes sure the people can stay in the countries and help them to build their own economy. I think that's very important.
Mm-hmm.
Because we can't save the whole world, but she takes a little part of every piece of the world a little bit and makes sure people can, and a lot of women, she gives small credits, she teaches them how to use it and why it's so important. I think it's a very big issue. It's very good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And she came from another country. She she adopted the Netherlands very, very well.
And she is also like we like to be women. She has three children, and I'm honest. She is doing her job. She works hard. She has humor. She is always. She speaks her languages. Yeah. I think she's a very good example for her.
Yeah. Yeah, and she. What I also like is that she's very feminine.
Yeah, yeah. And she's a very, very, I think she's a very good person. For
yeah.
Yes.
Wilma, you have a family business, so your daughter is involved in the business as well, and you told me that you are going to take a step back and that she's going to be the next generation. Why do you want to do a step back now?
It's not direct a step back, but it takes about 4 or 5 years, to be honest, to take the business over. She needs to get, she knows the business because she was raised with it, of course.
Yeah.
It takes time to get all the, to know how we forge the office, to meet our customers. We do international business, of course. So we go from Russia to the United States to Europe, a lot of countries. So it takes time to meet and learn, I think. I'm sure for that. So, yes.
And I have two daughters, and my oldest is 17. But I, at the moment, I cannot imagine having her in the business. So how is that for you, having your daughter in the business?
It's good, to be honest. And sometimes it can be, we are a little bit the same sometimes.
Uh-huh.
But no, we do different things. So
okay.
And we can speak quite well with each other. So I think it's a very good step because she did international business, so she knows a lot about other things. She can help me to grow. Because we want to grow the business in a few things.
Okay.
So that's her job.
Now, I know Laura is there and she's waiting to be introduced as well. I'm joining this interview, so I haven't seen her yet. So can you welcome her?
Yes, I will. Hello, Laura. Please enjoy us. Laura Schneeboer.
Hello.
Hey, hi, Laura. Nice to see you. Pleased to meet you. So, your mom has already introduced you a little. I think you've been listening on the background where we have been talking about. What interests me is what do you want to... your mom says it's important to grow the business. Do you have any idea how you can contribute to that?
Well, we actually just started a web shop in 2016.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that is a way to grow.
Mm-hmm.
Directly to the consumers.
Mm-hmm.
So we already started it and it's working very well, so hopefully we can do some more.
Yeah, interesting. And are you already now joining your dad or your mom on travels to foreign countries to yeah. other yeah?
Yes, sometimes we went to the United States to a couple of customers. In April we're going to Taiwan.
Mm-hmm.
So yes, we are visiting some customers. Yeah.
And what do you like the most about those international clients and doing business internationally?
I think it's interesting because even in the United States, the culture is different, and it's very interesting to do business with them because sometimes there are small miscommunications.
Mm.
What do they mean? And they're saying for us, so yeah, that's interesting. It always works eventually, but sometimes it takes a bit of time.
Yeah, and now you had your mother as an example in the business. What did she teach you? What do you think is what is one of the most important things you've learned from her?
Oh wow. Good question, yes. I think communication with the customers.
Mm-hmm.
So you can think some things like, oh, well, just be kind, just be, you know, yeah.
Different countries, different customers.
Yeah, sometimes it gets difficult, but then you're like, okay, relax,
yeah.
We're all human, and we'll try to work it out, and it's fine.
Yeah. So and you are going to at some point you are going to take over the company. Are you going to do that on your own or with somebody else of the family or?
No, together with my brother.
Uh huh.
He's working here sometimes, so he knows about the business and everything. But he wants to work at another company. He wants to travel a bit more, and then he feels he's ready to
later.
Join the company full time.
Wow. So, Wilma, you are really fortunate that your children want to be in the business, eh?
Yes. When she was younger, she was for sure she never would take over the business because people know that the name is quite famous in the gardening world. And then she said, no, it's not my job, never. But the international business, I think, is nice. We speak a lot of... different people, nice people, sometimes problems, but always 90% are really nice. We're passionate for the product we make.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's niche, it's a high end product, of course. We meet famous people also who work in the garden. You know, you don't think about famous people, but we know a lot of famous people who use our tools.
Yeah, so I've heard.
It gives you energy, you know? So,
Laura, I have another question for you. You studied international business. Now, I know from experience that at school or at university, things are usually a lot different than in reality. What are things that you have noticed that worked out totally different than you learned at school?
I think the total business is different than what you learn in school, because in school it's all theoretical and nothing ever works in theory how you think it's going to work. So it's always different. Every day it's different.
So you have to be very, very flexible and adaptable.
I think you learn the basics and then you start learning actually when you practice your
Yeah.
Mm. That's what I believe.
Yeah. So, ladies, I'm thrilled to have like a mother and a daughter in business in my talk show. That hasn't happened before. And when Wilma called me and proposed this, I thought, wow, you know, this is different than the format we usually have. But I think it's nice to see how the first you are the third generation, Wilma, and the fourth generation are continuing a family business. And what's your age, by the way, Laura? You look very young. Huh?
29.
Yeah, wow.
Yeah, it's a good age to take over.
Yeah. And how do you look towards the responsibility?
Yes, it's a bit scary.
Yeah.
Sometimes you're like, oh my God, what are we going to do? But yeah, I mean, they do it together. So that's why I knew very first I didn't want to do it alone. So I'm happy I will do it together with my brother, so you can divide the responsibility. I think that's a good thing.
Yeah. You know, and whenever things get scary, when it's over, you don't understand why you've been so scared, because you always manage, because you have to, you know. There's no way of walking back from an issue when you have a business. There's nobody else who can solve it. So you will learn that being scared, there's no need.
Well, I know already, but it happens in your mind.
I know, and that's what women tend to do. We make things bigger than they are, and I know when you trust in your heart, there are no issues.
Exactly, and we know the business. We know how to sell stuff. We know how to work, but it's more like, you know, she has to travel more later on. We need to travel a lot. We need to meet the customers. We do a very important show in London every year. We are 10 mm-hmm. days at the Chelsea Flower Show, the most international, the most famous show. And that's a nice part of there you learn also the business and how it works.
Yeah, so that's one of the things you always do, go to this major exhibition. What other things do you do to get international clients?
To be honest, we do this international business. The whole world is coming to the Chelsea Flower Show.
Yeah.
And further, we to be honest, we don't do a lot of shows. We did a few in Germany. But yeah, that's the shows we do three in a year. We do Chelsea Flower Show in London. We do one in Germany every year because it's a big customer and they want us to come there. So mm-hmm. And we do one in Holland. It's for the Netherlands, for the gardeners, it's the best one, we think.
Okay.
For the rest, we decided a few years ago, I think, to do the maintenance to the customer. Because as you told in the beginning, we have 240 tools. So we teach our customers to sell more tools. Then rather we look for new shops. Because we look for, it doesn't sound a bit arrogant, but we look for the high-end shops. We look for... You don't find this in a Walmart or mm-hmm. you know the big because we want people to have the passion and they need to know how we make the tools. It's very important for us. We almost know all our customers, to be honest.
Wow.
Even now I'm traveling to Russia next month. We mm-hmm. go to a Russian client, so they went to Europe. So they want us to come to them, so that's a nice part of the business, to be honest.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, the traveling, yeah. That's yeah. Sorry?
Yeah. The traveling, I like that to do. I like to do traveling.
Yeah, so do I. You do too, Laura?
Yes, meeting people is always interesting.
Yeah, exactly. I always find when I'm abroad, doing business is so much easier because then there's not all the admin things and all the, you know, it's just having the conversations with people and making things work. And and then you come back home and then you have to do all the other stuff.
Yeah. We go to customers, they love our products. So it's so easy to
sell.
It's easy to, if you have a good story, a good product, it's easy to, people understand what you are making. Yeah. So
it gives you energy to see if people are enthusiastic about your products.
I love that. And I love what you say, Wilma. You don't sell the product, you sell the story.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, yeah. Very, very smart. Well, ladies, I think we are coming to an end. Is there anything that we didn't talk about and that you want to mention?
No, I think we discussed the most. We always have a nice quote. I would like to say that we always say, once you have a sneeber in your hand, you never want to have something else. It's always something we like. So that's a quote we always use.
And I believe you have to change the name of the company, Schneeborg and Sons. I see it at the back.
True. Yeah.
So when the future generation.
It would be soon. Yeah. But it's English. If you pronounce the name Schneeborg, it's a typically Dutch name.
Yeah.
But not for the customers. They all pronounce it quite well to me.
Good. Excellent.
Nice. Yeah. And Sunday, like, yeah.
Okay, so if anybody wants to get in contact with you at the end of this talk show video, there will be an ad on how to get in touch with Wilma on social media and how to get in touch with the business. If you want to use their products or maybe know somebody who will benefit from selling the products, I believe you're open to connections. And Laura, I wish you all the best. I think you're very brave and that you just dive into this. We need strong women, Wilma, I agree, but young women, that's even more beautiful.
I'll do my best. Yeah.
You will, I believe.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much. And for if you're watching, I hope you enjoyed it. I think those beautiful women shared some valuable tips on how to do business international, but also on how to work together with your team and work together with your family. So I hope you enjoyed it. Look forward to talking to the audience for the next meeting. Bye-bye.
Okay.
Bye, ladies.
Thank you, Tineke. Bye-bye.